Okay, so I'll try and be as quick as I can. I know I'm on last, and we've been sitting down for nearly enough 2 hours now. What I'm going to say has already been said. My name is Matthew Jackson. I work for BIMobject. We are a startup, and we're not a startup. We've actually been around for 5-6 years, and we're already on the stock market. We went to stock market 4 years ago, and I was one of the early investors. I've been working with BIMobject for those 4 years so far, and it's been very successful. And I'll talk a little bit about what we're doing. But we have a big problem in the industry, which I think we've all discussed already. We need 3 billion new homes in cities by 2050. And we don't just need homes. We need all the infrastructure that goes around what a home is. So we need schools, we need hospitals, we need social infrastructure, we need 5G networks, because the 4G network isn't big enough for us to work in. As an industry today, we will never achieve this efficiently. We'll build crap that won't last, and you know, we need things to change. And one of the problems that we have is this problem. I'm in London, so I know that gin is a very popular drink here. Does the lack of good data cause us to look at the industry at building at cost but not value? There's been a great example about the schools in Belgium, which obviously were built at value. I am a gin drinker and a whiskey drinker. Not excessively, not to this much. But I can tell here that someone has made these purchases on cost. These are not fine spirits. These do not represent value to your taste buds. And this is a problem, because we are looking at how we build at a cost. We talked about things going over budget at a building. But is that important against the life cycle of what a building is? And I'm going to touch on that a little bit later, and the fact that we are in the digitalization of construction, and we have two or three roads to go down in potentially how we can use and how we can control the data that we have. I think it's been mentioned already, the industry needs to digitize or die. We've touched upon Carillion very quickly. It is very much the fact that those companies that don't digitise or start spending on digitisation will start to fall, even if they've been around for 50 to 100 years. It's an inevitable process. The big challenge in building all these homes and building these cities and building these railways is that we as designers, I'm an ex-architect myself, I would say that we haven't really changed the way we draw or model in the past 10 years. We have new tools, but fundamentally, the way that we're taught in architecture schools and the way that we come to a design in our minds is just enhanced through digital drawing. We don't actually make it better. The way we make it better is data, and clients, governments especially, are asking for a lot of data now. It's the data change that has happened. At BIMobject, we've been working with data for 6 years. We have the world's largest database on BIMobjects. What is a BIMobject? It's a digital version of something. We enable architects to download a digital version of this door, of this chair, maybe of this stage, which is slightly falling apart, and I'm slightly worried. So they can worry about designing a space and designing a quality design for the client rather than drawing all the little pieces. It's Lego bricks. It's digital Lego. We weren't the largest in our 6 years. There has been a journey. We had a competitor, Autodesk, world's biggest construction software company. This time last year, gave us the competing product, Seek. It's a $5 million business. To Autodesk, who are worth billions, it's nothing. To a little company like us of 70 people at the time, to be given a $5 billion per annum business was amazing. Because they understood that an independent business who is specializing in a task to perfect it is better than a big enterprise trying to do it themselves. So they gave us the business, they gave us the clients, and they gave us everything. And it's been a fantastic journey since then. And we realize now that being the world's largest database, which is awesome, we have thousands of brands, we have nearly 700,000 architects using our platform. What else can we do? We have loads and loads of data. So we've started looking at and experimenting with how we can bring design to the client. This is a model in a web browser. You can do this in Internet Explorer or Safari or Chrome. No software involved. This is a platform. Keep it simple. Keep it real low tech. We can send this to a link to somebody and they can access a model and they can start interrogating information. We're bringing data to the masses. We're lowering the entry. But the really exciting thing about this is what's in a building that's going to be built, or what is already in my building that has been built. And that is, we're really starting to look at data, business analytics and business interrogation of data. What's inside my building? And how can I share this information with these other startups to make this data better, to make it more valuable, and make it more usable for the clients? And that is what the industry wants to do, and we believe that's where the industry needs to go, with having and enriching data. And it has to be in a platform. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, but death to Excel. As soon as you make an Excel spreadsheet, it is out of date. It has no relationship with anything else that is involved in the industry, because you have exported it. It's not live, it's not connected to anything at all. So no more Excel. The data has to be shared in the cloud, through collaborative platforms, between ourselves here in the front row. And the other thing, by doing this, and by having this data, and being able to interrogate this data, we can start looking at TCO, which is total cost of ownership. This is a buzz term that will definitely flare up more and more and more over the coming years. What do I mean by total cost of ownership? We're working with the British government. I'm also doing some work with the Japanese government and the Americans. I fly all over the world. And this is a really, really, really important thing. For every pound or dollar we spend on design, we spend tenfold on construction, and we spend 100-fold on managing a facility. I used to design schools and hospitals. I was part of the PFI and PPP programs, and I can talk firsthand about how not value for money they are. But if we can give good data, then the Department of Education or Department of Justice can manage their estate effectively and know how much it's going to cost over 50 years before they build it, because we can give them analytical data on how much everything has cost from the past. There is another reason why constructions go over budget. It's because nobody actually knows how much they cost. The number one question I get from going to see a government is, tell me how much 1 kilometre of road costs to build. Nobody knows the answer. It's guesswork. And it is guesswork all the time because we don't have the data to hand. And to have good data, another thing that a lot of people are going to be talking about is the single source of truth. So this again makes Excel redundant in our workflows because you're starting to have copies. The single source of truth is that there is only one copy of something. You can share that data between each other, but the data has a source, it has a home, and it has a truth, and it can be trusted. And again, these processes don't really exist today, apart from maybe some of the people that are here working on them. The big question is, how can we move data from the building product manufacturers over here on the left that make all the materials that go into our buildings across the supply chain, which is the architects, the engineers, the business guys and the delivery mechanisms into construction, and then sending that to the client. Because at the end of the day, all of us in here work for the client. All of us. Whether you make software or not. The money all comes from the client, the money all comes from governments and big business, and they're the ones that are going to save. And it's been said already, it is the death of enterprise and the birth of the ecosystem. Absolutely. It is coming, it is here today. We are not interested in a tool that can do everything. I've used some of the systems that were mentioned, and they do everything on average. We need things that are the best of breed, and we put them together, and we make APIs. Your data is their castle for these big enterprises, because they can just build more tools and satisfy the big client, because you're so invested. And that's a terrible idea. So as we've discussed, APIs. We have an API, we're 6 years old. We're building our APIs, and we're working with some of the guys here. We're working with people like Microsoft. Biggest, one of the biggest companies in the world is asking us for data. a little 150-person Swedish company. We're being asked by them to provide data. This is how much it's wanted by the industry. And we've practiced it ourselves. We have lots of different modules, and we're APIing between our departments. Again, to have better data flow and make it better efficient. So, what can happen? What can we do? This is a real life example project of us using APIs to give technology. This is a supermarket, ICA, Swedish. It's a bit like Sainsbury's, about the same size, same quality. And we're using different technologies here. We're viewing a supermarket in construction in the cloud. And now we've gone round and we've scanned it with photographs. And we've started tagging information in these photographs with real life products. Going to real life information so I know what door there is. And I, you know, this is facility management at a really base level. This is the next step. None of this big complex stuff that we need. It's photographs stitched together, and you're just pointing people in the right direction to find data. And we can go one step further now. How about we start incorporating an IoT device as well? We don't make IoT devices, but we know people who do. And we can connect our data together. So I can now start getting readings on information from IoT devices in a really basic model that I can view online. This is simple technology and simple connections together. Just through the magic of APIs, just through companies being the best at what they can be at, and working together to produce an enterprise-level solution through ecosystems. And again, we can take information. This is in a VR headset. So stick on a VR headset if you haven't before, and go and explore how construction can be better in VR, how facility management can be better in VR, and how we can overlay information and make it touchable at our hands. It's great fun. It is a bit freaky if you've not done VR and AR experiences before, but it's where this industry will go to. It's not out there 5-10 years away. It's definitely today. So to wrap up, for sure 100% in construction, because we are so far behind everybody else. The data is 100% new oil. I, as an early investor in BIM objects, so far doing very well. And we are on the stock market here on NASDAQ, OMX North. Go buy some shares. Very good. But we're also moving into new areas as well. And with the help of these guys, and it's vice versa as well. We'll help each other to produce something which is amazing. So data is a new oil. Contextual data is information which is useful for the client, because that's who we are all being paid by. We're all being paid by government and big business. And information is power. The people that hold that information, the people who hold these databases and know how to use it, will take the industry by storm. So welcome to the ecosystem revolution, welcome to total cost of ownership, and welcome to the single source of truth. Thank you very much.
Grace, thank you very much for that. Ladies and gents, we have time for a bit of refreshments now and a bit of chat for networking. It's about 10 to, so.